very crazy. Justin Ramos! Money. That's what that is. That's that tax money shit.
That's that shit.
Make you think of Scarface when they rolling up them things. Yeah. You want to go to war? Okay. How y'all doing, Long Island? Y'all look good, man. Y'all looking good. Give yourselves a round of applause. This shit is sold out. Look around. Look around. This shit is sold out. Yeah. A couple people went to take a shit, but it's okay. It's all right. Not you, not you. But you looked at me, so now. Yeah, man. Y'all looking good, man. I hope y'all had a good time. Give it up for all the comics y'all saw thus far, man. Yeah. She threw her wig off. Then she told the white dude, taste it, taste it. She didn't say taste it, but that's what she wanted. It taste it, yeah. Oh, man. How many of y'all believe in that Zika virus bullshit? That shit is bullshit. I asked my cousin about that. I was like, yo, that Zika virus is real. He said, nah, I'm tired of that bitch. We had 5 kids already. She trying to talk about the one that she pregnant with now. That ain't my baby. Bitch always making up a new virus. Last time it was the bird flu. I was like, bitch, fuck you and that Zika virus. That pussy ain't that good to call it Zika virus. Yeah, man, ISIS got people scared as shit. Who's scared of ISIS? Be honest. Stop lying. When they kidnap your ass, you're gonna be scared. People in New York ain't playing that shit, man. This dude walked into a convenience store in Queens and slapped the shit out of her, Muhammad. He was like, you ISIS? Muhammad's brother was on Brooklyn 1, like, yo. This is my brother Muhammad. The guy yelled, I see, we only have Ben and Jenny's. We only have Haagen-Dazs, we don't have Icy. We work so hard in this country. First I get separate cut, you know, hot dog 150. Then I get halal cut. Now I get Muhammad and Muhammad convenience store. He want Icy. Icy go on sale in June. After August, only Haagen-Dazs. ISIS, man. You know what I'm saying? Listen, I'm a product of the 80s. I grew up in the 90s, right? Hulk Hogan was the greatest wrestler ever, right? When the fuck did he become the greatest porn star? When? He got $125 million for a minute and 30 seconds. Right? And leave it up to him to be a white guy to win a court case with a do-rag on, right? If I was in there with a do-rag on, they'd be like, Mr. Ramos, 25 years, it's over. Hulk Hogan, man. You see, when he was on the stand, they was like, well, Mr. Hogan, we saw in the video that you said you had a 10-inch, you know, penis. He was like, no, brother, I got 20-inch pythons. What are you talking about? My nutsack is 20 inches, but cock is out the wall. No, can't. Don't worry, I got somebody. My man was lying on his dick on the stand. Little brother. What is that? That must be the Long Island Railroad. I'm paranoid. I'm from East New York, Brooklyn, okay? I got a reason to be paranoid. All right? You ever been there? Shit. I'm glad I made it out of there today. I was just visiting my mom. I was like, yeah. Somebody got popped in the head yesterday in the daytime. Yeah. Yep. But East New York is coming up, though, man. They just won an Academy Award, yeah? Yep, there's a new movie out by East New York. It's called Mad Max Fury Road. You guys should check it out. East New York is so bad that the Denny even 24/7. That's how bad East New York is. Anywhere outside of New York, East New York is, Denny's is open 24/7. Am I bullshitting? Not in East New York, that shit closed at 10:15. They're like, no, we not doing no bulletproof glass with the spinning window, no. We don't accept wink, we want cash only. These pancakes ain't worth my life. Fuck you. It was like the diner that was here before. They used to get robbed at 6 a.m., 3 p.m. No, we don't care if we got the Craigslist security guard. Fuck that, we closing at 10:15. That's... East New York is terrible. That's why I got me and my wife, we got the fuck out of there. We live with all the white folks now in North Williamsburg or whatever. That's what happens. When they come to your town, Bed-Stuy ain't even Bed-Stuy no more. Stuyvesant Heights. Yep, that's what they do. They add a Heights on everything. Yep. Long Island, they about to change y'all to Williamsburg. Y'all keep playing around. You better pay taxes. Because Williamsburg just gonna stretch all the way from... Oh my God, man, I love where I'm from, man. I'll tell you a little bit, I'll explain this, okay? Because I know some of y'all are like, yo, was he listening to the last Drake album? What's going on here? I'll explain it. I am Afro-American and Puerto Rican, right? So this is the black half, my eyebrows are, yeah. I only see my dad on Saturdays and Sundays, so if you come up to me after the show, go like that, I'm gonna just give you the general answer. I'm gonna be like, donde está casa de Pepe, okay? That's as far as my Spanish goes. It's gone. I could tell you everything about fatback and collard greens, but I don't know nothing about that sofrito and all that other empanada and all that queso branco and all that stuff. I don't know nothing about that. And when I used to go over to my dad's house, them battles between my grandparents, my abuelo and my abuela, epic, okay? My grandfather had nerve to complain, okay? This dude had the sugar, okay? He was in the wheelchair my whole childhood, no legs. He bitching over her cooking.
Mira, Aria, pero today the cooking too spicy. It's too spicy.
Motherfucker, you in the wheelchair. Shut the fuck up, okay? Don't say nothing. One time, she took the chicken bone off his damn, took it right off his plate. Then,
get spicy, get pique, where? Get pique.
By the time she was finished with yelling at him, he had shredded chicken on his damn plate. She just ripped everything off the bone.
Spicy, where?
Every time they got into a damn fight, she would go in her room, because, you know, they had separate rooms. I don't know if any of you guys experienced that. They married for like 30-some-odd years. They live in separate rooms. Real shit. She would go in her room because he couldn't get over the carpet. He had a wheelchair. And they had this bar like this right here. He couldn't get over that, huh? You said they had the damn thing just cursing out. I can't come today. I bet you they chicken no spicy now, huh, motherfucker, huh? They chicken no spicy. You can't come here. Not today. They can't be here. You want to come later to get the coochie-coochie, not today. How's the chicken now, huh? How's the chicken now, cabrón? One time they had an argument. I don't know how he put a damn hammer, a hammer that you put nails into the wall. He had it in his pocket. He cursed her out. Because sometimes he couldn't really get in the bathroom because of the wheelchair, you know? So he had a little porta potty. And he was doing number two on the porta potty. And they had an argument about the chicken from the day before. Right? So she got tired of it because he kept, chicken spicy, chicken spicy. She took his wheelchair and put it to the front of the house. This motherfucker, I bullshit you now. He wiped his ass so fast. Started chasing. He chased her on his hands.
He chicken no spicy today, huh?
Make fun. Couldn't get over. Start doing the dance. Be like, dun, 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 dun. You can't do that, huh? Your legs don't work. It's true shit, man. I asked for permission to tell that joke. My grandma, that's okay. He died anyway. It's no problem. He not here no more. He's in the heaven. My grandfather lived a long time. He died when he passed. He was like 85, so he lived the life. You know what I'm saying? My mother's family, I have a big family. My mother, black side, I still have great aunts and uncles that are still alive. You know? My grandmother's brother's 89. He's gonna be 89 in October. When you get to that age, You don't give a fuck
what comes out your mouth.
He haven't called me Justin in 29 years. Since I was born, I've been that dirty Puerto Rican motherfucker,
man. Oh, man, here come that dirty Puerto Rican. Coming to my house, gonna eat up my fish fry. Fucking up the Lebanon James game and shit.
Who the fuck is Lebanon James? You mean LeBron James?
Say, look, little nigga, you know what I'm talking about. Lebanon, he come out, he got the hairline fucked up, he got the chalk. Throw it in the air. Trying to let him see if he get another ring and shit, you know? Lebanon.
Yo, he's talking about you don't want to get old, which is impossible. You can't beat time. That's one thing you can't beat. You have time, but you can't beat it. You'll get old, you know?
He's like, when you get 89, you got to wear the pants. You ain't gonna be wearing no more of them Burberry boxers, Polo Ralph Lauren, and Tommy Hilfiger. You're gonna be wearing a man's diapers, Depends. I wanna be the new spokesperson for Depends. Cause when you rang the doorbell, I thought the rent was due, I shit on myself. And then I thought, Depends is gonna depend on me. That's the story. Depends on me.
Give it up for this mic, man. It's got the. I don't know if these are Energizer batteries, but they can get it out.
But it's okay, we gonna work with it.
Yeah, man. It's hard being married in a social media world. You know what I mean? Really hard. You got Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, Tumblr, with all the naked chicks, you got everything. My wife, I don't have that many followers, okay? I got close to 1,500 followers, which ain't a lot. You know what I'm saying? Compared to some of these people who got thousands of followers, like Cardi B.
You know what I'm saying? It is funny.
Yeah. My wife knows every female follower of mine that likes a picture, because she reads it. Because when you get over 10 likes, they don't show the names anymore. It just says the amount of likes. So I've been trying to tell her for months that this girl that's been following me is a new comedian I'm trying to help out. But she don't believe me. Every time she like a picture of me, anything. Like this picture that my boy is taking right now. She gonna like it. My wife gonna call me as soon as the show's over.
Who is this bitch, shots of cocaine? And why the fuck is she liking your picture?
I was like, no, she's a comic. I'm trying to help.
Stop lying, motherfucker. You sent the emoji back to her with the tongue hanging out with the hand. I went on the bitch page, the shit said book me. What the bitch do? What does she do? It just said book me. She don't do nothing else? She's selling weeds by the bundle. She got Remy. What the fuck she got? That Malaysian. What she got? She's selling the Slim Me tees. What the fuck she got? Waist trainers? That bitch ain't no comedian. I ain't never seen her on BET. Paolo.
It's hard too, man, when you walking in the street and you see a bad chick, you try to see her before she reached the point of you and your lady, and you play that shit off. You pull out your cell phone, like, damn, man, these niggas ain't doing shit this year.
And she's like, oh, don't try to play that like you reading the ESPN. This ain't first take, motherfucker. I see you first take a look at that bitch. I was like, babe, I wasn't looking at her. I looked at her tights, and I was like, but yo ass. You better never come out the house like that, because your ass too big for them rainbow tights. She got on
them tights. Them rainbow tights on your big ass would be like, help me!
Busting out the seams. She got the big booty. She'd be like, well, don't be trying to butter me up now.
My wife is a trip, man. I'm sad that The Walking Dead is over, man. That is my show.
Yes.
Walking Dead fans?
Yes.
I love that fucking show, man. In my neighborhood, they do Walking Dead parties, right? During the season, you go to this bar, you dress up like a zombie or Daryl or Carl or one of those characters, or Michonne. Badass Michonne with the... They had to stop, though. A lot of homeless people kept coming in. It's like, I'm here for the Walking Dead party. Shit out of white people.
It's like, sir, you stink. No, bitch, I'm dead. Those are brains.
You don't watch the show.
I want to know how you watch the show.
That's me on the glass every week. I come off my cardboard and I'm on the glass like, ah. Now, where's my wings I'm supposed to get for when? I'm in costume, bitch.
Walking Dead. Ridiculous, man. Yeah, man. I lost a lot of weight, man. I 3 years ago, I was like 220. 220. Yep. Then I joined Planet Fitness. I was still 220. Now I lost weight. Stop eating at Planet Fitness. I'm 198 pounds again. Like, I'm not even a heavyweight no more. I feel like I can take on Floyd Mayweather soon, you know? You ever been to Planet Fitness? They got free pizza, free bagels. When you check in, they got a tin of Tootsie Rolls. Is this a gym or a restaurant? Last time I checked, restaurants have ratings, A. But they got A for pizza? How fast do they order Papa John's? That's what I want to know. And then the girls, yo, you ever see the women that go to this gym? Full makeup, matching tights, matching Jordans. All they do is cardio. You don't never see them touch a weight. This brother know what I'm talking about. Chicks be on the Stairmaster for hours. I gotta work on my glutes. They got all these weird signs all over the gym. It's not what you eat, it's how you eat it. Yeah, because you're serving pizza. Everybody at that gym is fat. They never lose weight. That's how they keep you coming in. Keep feeding you and feeding you.
Like, well, it's only $10 a month. What are you complaining about?
It's not even a real gym. A gym's not supposed to have purple and yellow machines. A gym's not supposed to smell like cotton candy. A gym's supposed to smell like balls all the time. Just balls. All the time. Yeah, man. Ridiculous. Hot balls. Like, a gym is supposed to look like the scene in Rocky 3 when he lost the eye of the tiger and Apollo took him to Detroit and all those sweaty dudes walking around the gym. He's like, you see that rock? That's the eye of the tiger. You know what I mean? The fucking trainers there with the yellow shirts, they don't do nothing at Planet Fitness. They wiping down machines. You done with that pizza? Here you go. A trainer's supposed to be like Paulie. Be like, you can't train him like a colored fighter. He's got no rhythm. Like that. That's how it's supposed to be. Get the hand roll. You can't train him like a colored fighter. He's got no rhythm. He's a cracker. I don't know. I love Italians, though, man. That's probably why Sly is one of my favorite actors, man. I love Italians. I hate my landlord, though. My landlord is Italian. He don't fix shit, okay? Me and my wife are the only black, half Spanish, because I explained earlier, family in the building, right? He don't fix shit. For 6 years, we had mushrooms on our ceiling in the bathroom. 6 years. Yeah. My wife is an asthmatic. She's been complaining for 6 years. It's like, Jay, you need to tell her about the mushrooms. I was like, I'm going to have a talk with him and make him fix them damn mushrooms. So next time he came for the rent, I was like, excuse me, buddy, listen. We got fucking mushrooms going on our fucking ceiling, you understand? You want your rent, you got to remove those mushrooms, okay? Because every time I'm using the Dove body wash, I don't want to see mushrooms on my fucking ceiling. I only want to see mushrooms in the fucking pot. You know what I'm talking about over here? When my wife is making the pasta, it's supposed to be in the kitchen, not in the fucking bedroom. You understand? You fix that shit the next day. Son of a bitch. Italians are crazy though, man. I took a 10-hour OSHA class for construction. I know nothing about construction, so I'm a bad Spanish person, number one. And when I took the class, the guy the first day, he was there teaching us about scaffold. It was Italian though. He's like, oh, hey buddy, today's your scaffolding class over here. We got your basic scaffolding over here. You got the baseboard. All right, let me tell you guys a story. I got my cousin a fucking job, right? His only job for $15 an hour.
Which one?
Was to sweep a fucking broom. That's it. All right? $15 a fucking hour. At 11 a.m., after he's been there for a fucking hour, I get a call from the company. They say, oh, your cousin's in Lenox Hill. I'm like, what the fuck is he doing there? He was sweeping all day. That's all he was supposed to do. It was like, well, you know, Vinny, you know, your cousin, he fucking drove a forklift off to the second floor. I'm like, how this cocksucker gonna drive a fucking forklift if he was fucking sweeping? So anyway, this is your basic scaffolding. You got the baseboard and the poles. 4 hours of this shit. Like, this is ridiculous. ridiculous. It was free, so I didn't complain, yeah? Yeah, man. Man, I used to do a lot of partying when I